Hello friends, welcome back. We are here with the third lecture of the chapter one, which is Introduction to Environmental Studies. And today we will start with a brief history of environmentalism, right? So today's class lecture will be based on a brief history of environmentalism where we left last time. So as all of you know that there are times which have been after the Industrial Revolution or even before that, where the environment was not that much concern. So let us know the history, what happened and how this came into notice of the people. So the Industrial Revolution, jisko aap audyogik kranti bolte hain, sparked between 1730 and 1850, right? So this was the era where we were talking about Industrial Revolution and the things were developing very fast, which has significantly altered our planet Earth in a very short span. So during this period, we see the rapid industrialization and growth have happened in a small span. Bahut hi kam time mein bahut zyada growth ho gaya. Everything was developing like very fast. The concern for the environment protection led to the movement known as environmentalism. So basically, why we were concerned for the environmental protection? So it already led to a movement called environmentalism, right? So wahan se ek, jise aap kehte hain, andolan type ka develop hua. So there are various reasons for protecting the planet, and now we were having reasons. हमारे पास कुछ कुछ कारण थे दैट व्हाई वी वांट टू प्रोटेक्ट आवर प्लैनेट. फॉर सम इट्स जस्ट फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ ह्यूमंस. सम पीपल वर मोर टुवर्ड्स लाइक एंथ्रोपोसेंट्रिक. दे वर थिंकिंग फॉर द ह्यूमन बेनिफिट कि हमारा इससे नुकसान हो रहा है, दैट्स व्हाई वी शुड प्रोटेक्ट इट. एंड फॉर अदर्स इट्स बिकॉज फॉर द नेचर. एंड सम वर नो डाउट नेचर लवर दैट वी शुड प्रोटेक्ट आवर नेचर और द अर्थ और द रिसोर्सेज ऑफ द वाटर, सॉइल, एयर, राइट. The movement has become a force for protect environment. So at this time, we saw a force was developing that we have to protect our environment. So with this, it started. And the first was like 1850 to 900. So during this period, 1850 to 1900, environmentalists such as Henry David Thoreau, who was like from 1870 to 1862, and writers like John Moore, who was there for 1834 to 1940, find their tongue inspired by visionaries like Thor and Moore. So these were some of the visionaries jinko future ke bare mein kafi kuch environment ki concern dikh rahi thi. So environmental awareness began to spread through the Western world. So sabse pehle Western countries mein they show a concern about the change environment, kyunki development bhi wahi pe pehle sabse zyada hua tha, right? So it was sure that the damage which is done to environment pe jo damage hoga, जो भी इन्वायरमेंट में प्रॉब्लम आई होगी, सबसे पहले वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड में स्टार्ट हुई थी. तो वहीं से एक अवेयरनेस का फील डेवलप हुआ, राइट. एंड इन दिस 1900 टू 1950 द अवेयरनेस ग्रोज वेल. काफी कुछ अवेयर लोग हो गए थे वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड में, राइट. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट विलियम हॉर्ने, सो ही रोट समथिंग अबाउट वाइल्ड लाइफ. जो आपकी बायोडाइवर्सिटी है, जैसे वाइल्ड लाइफ है, जो हमारे ऑर्गेनिजम्स है, he wrote one literature that is Vanishing Wildlife in 1913, right? And he was the first biodiversity conserving person. Like, he was a conservationist, right? Jo aapki jaiv vividhta hoti hai usko bachane ke liye, he did the first effort. And to draw the attention to the plight of endangered wildlife, jo bhi hamari wildlife hai, jaise jo bhi aapke forest mein या वनों में जीव रहते हैं, जंतु रहते हैं, राइट, फॉर देम. एंड उसमें से भी जो एकदम एक्सटिंक्ट होने के एंगल से, सो वो आर लाइक एट द वर्ज ऑफ एक्सटिंक्शन और सम आर दर एंडेंजर्ड, जो बिल्कुल विलुप्त होने वाले हैं, राइट. सो इन 1949 एल्डो लियोपोल्ड, राइट, ही ऑल्सो पब्लिश अ लिटरेचर कॉल्ड एज अ सैंड कंट्री अल्मेंसे, which is often regarded as the most influential book on conservation ever written. So this was the first book written by Leopold, which highlighted the importance of conservation, ki why we should concern about our biodiversity, why we should conserve, jo hamari jaiv vividhta hai, hum usse kyun bachana chahiye. So Leopold was the first one to highlight in this book, and it was like one of the very influential book which make people thought of conserving the biodiversity. तो लोगों को ये सोचने पे मजबूर होना पड़ा कि वी शुड कंजर्व आवर बायोडायवर्सिटी बिकॉज इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर आवर एनवायरमेंट. Then 1970s में, the movement ऑलमोस्ट स्टार्टेड हो चुका था एनवायरमेंटल अवेयरनेस का एंड पीपल वर अवेयर एंड मोस्टली द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड. देन कम अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फेज वेयर द वेयर मेनी वुड एग्री दैट द माइलस्टोन मेकिंग ऑफ द बर्थ ऑफ द एनवायरमेंटल मूवमेंट. सो सबसे ज्यादा जो पुश या थ्रेट एनवायरमेंटल मूवमेंट्स को मिला दैट वॉज दिस रिचल कार्सन्स वर्क, राइट. So she is no more now, but in 1962 she wrote a book which is Silent Spring. So from here the sparking thing started. So it is very important. Rachel Carson's 1962 he wrote a book which is called as Silent Spring. So isme in this book Rachel Carson describe about the ill effect of the pesticide insecticides such as DDT, which is basically used to kill the insects. Like jaise aap dekhte white color ka powder hota hai. पहले यूज किया जाता था टू कंट्रोल द मॉस्किटोज, राइट. बट नाउ एट मोस्ट ऑफ द प्लेसेस इट हैव बीन बैन बिकॉज इट वाज ऑर्गेनोक्लोरीन पेस्टिसाइड, राइट. उसको बैन कर दिया गया है बिकॉज ऑफ लुकिंग इनटू द हार्मफुल इफेक्ट इनटू द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एंड अदर स्पीशीज. सो कार्लसन, राइट, अ नेचर लवर एंड अ फॉर्मर मरीन बायोलॉजिस्ट. सो मरीन बायोलॉजिस्ट थे ये, मतलब सी बायोडाइवर्सिटी के ऊपर शी वॉज यूज टू वर्किंग फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ टाइम. टोल्ड हाउ केमिकल्स लाइक पेस्टिसाइड्स an insecticide. So the pesticides are those compounds which are used to kill pest and insect, right? And then we have division of these pesticides and insecticide on the different categories, like we have organochlorine, organophosphate, carbamates. So these are some category, but here we will keep them limited. So used on farms. So basically agriculture ne kafi use ho raha tha us samay insecticides ka. So the insect and pest which used to spoil the crops. So we used to have a use of these insecticides in forest, farms and gardens were contaminating the environment. But ultimately the bad effect was that this DDT was contaminating our environment. And because of this, most of the wildlife, jo humare wahan pe organisms the forest mein, animals the, they were getting poison, right? So she said because the insect life was dying and not just the pest species, which mean no food for the birds, right? So kafi sare insect, even because this was non-targeted, so other insects which are even not targeted by the DDT, which are not harmful for the crops, they were getting died, right? And then birds will not get their food. Ab koi insect hi nahi hai to chote mote kide khake guzara karte hain birds, but if there was no insect then no birds. अल्टीमेटली बर्ड्स भी नहीं होंगे, बर्ड्स भी डाई कर जाएंगे जो हमारा इकोसिस्टम है उसमें. इफ देयर विल बी नो इंसेक्ट फॉर देयर फूड देन नो बर्ड्स मींस नो सॉन्ग. सो दैट्स व्हाई शी गेव द नेम साइलेंट स्प्रिंग, कि जो आपके बर्ड्स हैं द काइंड ऑफ साउंड्स दे प्रोड्यूस और दे सिंग ड्यूरिंग द स्प्रिंग सीजन. सो दैट्स व्हाई शी नेम्ड द बुक एज साइलेंट स्प्रिंग एंड दिस बेसिकली हाईलाइटेड द इफेक्ट ऑफ डीडीटी, which is basically an organochlorine pesticide. Nowadays it has been banned most of the country. So people were in a grave danger too. And ultimately human beings bhi kafi isse impact ho rahe the, right? And she described in detail that how this chemical like DDT, which is dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane, basically DDT stands for dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane. So it is a complex structure and a chemical compound. So what happened? It enters into the food chain. So what happened once it is in there in the crop and in the marine animals, so ultimately these food crops or these marine animals such as fish, so they will be taken first it will accumulate into the body of these birds or the crops, and then it will basically in the body of these animals it accumulate in fatty tissue, right? Fatty tissue, or we call them as adipose tissue also, right? Adipose, which is basically the fat tissue, right? Adipose tissue. So it get accumulated there. And for example, agar main ye bolun aapko ki fish ki body mein accumulate ho raha hai, fish will be eaten by human being, right? And ultimately it will get accumulated into the body of human being, and which results in higher risk of the cancer. So it is basically carcinogen, it is cancer causing, right? Aur ye aapka biomagnification show karta hai, means agar across the food chain आप देखेंगे तो इट इंक्रीज अक्रॉस द फूड चेन एंड द कंसंट्रेशन कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग एट हायर लेवल, जो भी आपके ट्रॉफिक लेवल होते हैं, व्हिच वी विल डील इन द इकोसिस्टम यूनिट बेसिकली. सो बायो एक्युमुलेशन और बायो मैग्निफिकेशन का प्रॉब्लम इसने शो किया डीडीटी ने, दैट्स व्हाई इट वाज क्वाइट प्रॉब्लमैटिक, राइट. देन डिस्पाइट देयर आर लॉट ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म इन मीडिया बिकॉज दैट टाइम पीपल वर जस्ट about to aware about the environment and attempts by the chemical industry. So the chemical industries which were manufacturing these pesticides, they were behind Rachel Carson and they want to ban the book, right? And but scientific community, many of the scientists, they have backed her up and her work was validated. And then ultimately the president of USA, John F. Kennedy, right? So John F. Kennedy ordered an independent inquiry. So usko inquire kiya gaya ki bhai dekhte hain kitna isme sach hai kitna jhoot hai, right? Or we should ban this book or not. So investigation into the issue highlighted that in the book, so the Carson was found to be correct. And ultimately what is proven that Rachel Carson was right. And this compound dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane or DDT, it is basically poisoning our biodiversity or isse cancer ka bhi risk hai. Right. So it was banned and the effect of the other chemicals were scrutinized and similar kind of pesticides, right, were also investigated ki bhai kya problem these pesticides are causing in our biodiversity and at the level of human. But the real legacy of Silent Spring, right, the real legacy of the Silent Spring was a new public awareness. Aur yahan se kya hua ki ek different sort of awareness jo hai पब्लिक के अंदर स्प्रेड होना स्टार्ट हो गया बिकॉज नाउ इट वॉज वेल प्रूवन बाय रिचर्ड कार्सन्स बुक दैट यस दीज केमिकल्स आर गोइंग टू हार्म द एनवायरमेंट एज वेल एज ह्यूमन बीइंग सो द एनवायरमेंट वॉज बीइंग डैमेज्ड बाय ह्यूमंस राइट सो बिकॉज वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग दोज पेस्टिसाइड राइट एंड देन प्रीवियसली डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ द प्लैनेट हैज बीन अ कंसर्न ऑफ जस्ट ऑफ द फ्यू पीपल एंड नाउ we are bothered by the loss of the wilderness. So ab bahut sare log isse jud gaye the and now we are thinking ki hamari jo wildlife loss ho rahi hai, biodiversity loss ho rahi hai, we should think about it. But the news had now spread that our own lives were at risk and the issue could no longer be ignored. So because in this book that highlighted that also that because the DDT, it is a threat of having a cancer in human being, right? And those food crops or marine organisms such as fish is ultimately taken by human being, right? So the necessity, so they feel the necessity ki zarurat ho gayi hai ab to bilkul to regulate our behavior in order to protect the environment. So yahan se there was a different sort of wave, ek alag tarah ki lehar jaag gayi public ke andar. Now we have to protect our environment because a widely debated nation, right? So modern environmentalism was born और यहाँ पे जाके आपका modern environmentalism का birth हुआ या हम कहेंगे कि जो हमारा new environmentalism था वो यहाँ से develop होना start हुआ then we came into the era of 1970 right हम 1970 के दौर में आ गए और वहां से अब तो क्या है कि new environmentalism का एक chapter start ho gaya tha modern environmentalism ka. So in 1970s what we see international cooperation. Now different countries were cooperating with each other in order to save the environment because they have realized this that though we are doing development but our environment is getting threatened because of the all the activities or all sort of different sort of activities done on the earth. So environmental pressure groups Friends of the Earth and Greenpeace were both established in 1971. So some of the organizations have come ahead like Greenpeace, you might have heard, and then certain peer groups such as Friends of the Earth, right? Is tarah ke jo aapke organizations the, they start forming. They introduced flagship campaign for threatened species and they started a movement. We have to save the threatened species, jin bhi species ko ya biodiversity ko. There is a threat that they can get extinct. Unko hume save karna hai. So some of the species, initial species were like some of the initial species such as pandas, right? Then tigers, you might have seen they want to save. Then they inform the world that trade in elephant ivory, rhino horn and sea fur. So this is quite important, right? कि ये इन सब चीजों का ट्रेड नहीं होना चाहिए जैसे आपका हाथी दांत है या जो रीनो का हॉर्न होता है सींग या सी की जो स्किन होती है फर होती है सील फर राइट जो आप देखते हैं सो दे आर दे शुड बी कंप्लीटली स्टॉप्ड बिकॉज दे आर थ्रेटनिंग सम ऑफ द स्पीशीज व्हिच आर अबाउट टू एक्सटिंक्ट सो दैट्स व्हाई दे क्रिएटेड एन अवेयरनेस एंड अल्टीमेटली इन ईयर 1972 व्हाट हैपेंड In year 1972, we saw the first of the 10 yearly Earth Summit. So then here come the starting of the Earth Summit, that ki bhai hume Earth ke baare mein kuch sochna hai, how to conserve the species, and we have to take this matter of saving our environment seriously. Because international cooperation ka daur aa chuka tha is time pe, and people were really concerned about their environment. So that's why they started this international cooperation thing. And in year 1972, this year is very important from the environmental perspective. So first of the 10 yearly Earth Summit started, right? And first Earth Summit held in Stockholm, Sweden, right? So Stockholm is a place in Sweden, right? And it is generally considered to be the primary defining event of international environmentalism. So yahan se you can say that we started the safeguard of our environment, or the events or the campaign of saving our environment, at international platform. And this we named as international environmentalism, that people get united at an international platform. The Earth Summit, officially called as officially we call it as United Nations Conference on Human Environment. So Earth Summit ka jo official name hai, that is United Nations Conference on Human Environment, which has happened 1972 in Stockholm, Sweden. And this was initiated by the developed world. So Western countries ne pehle isko start kiya tha to address the environmental effects, right, of industrialization. So sirf ye dekhne ke liye ki jo aapki audyogik kranti hai uska kya effect ho raha hai environment ke upar, what cost it is going to cause to our environment, and how it is damaging. So how our environment is getting affected from the industrialization or whatever development we are doing. And initially 113 nations ne isko attend kiya tha. 113 nations participated in, and Sweden was concerned about acid rain. So Sweden ke paas kya issue tha ki bhai acid rain bahut zyada ho rahi hai our environment mein, right? Ki hum bahut zyada okay, so acid rain bahut zyada ho rahi hai. Then Japan was concerned about the industrial poisoning of their sea, ki hamare jo seas hai, Japan ne wahan pe issue raise kiya ki our seas are getting lot of waste, or the poisons which is poisoning our sea, and oil tanker spilling, right? Their cargoes were a concern worldwide. So ये सब चीजें वहाँ पे address की गई जो first 1972 में Earth Summit हुआ, और you can say United Nations Conference on Human Environment, right? So this was the starting point. Then what happened? Ahead of that. The conference produced some successes, including the 26 principle of declaration. So, एक 26 सूत्री कार्यक्रम जो आप कहते हैं वहाँ पे बनाया गया, declare किया गया, principle sign हुआ, declaration sign हुई, of the United Nations Conference on Human and Environment, an action plan for the human environment and environmental fund, right? So this was started there, and 26 principle of declaration पे agree किए सारे nations. Another significant outcome was the establishment of the UNEP. Or UNEP hamesha ke liye establish ho gaya, United Nations Environmental Program, right? Jo aap bolte hai na Sanyukt Rashtra Sangh, right? Usme jo environment ke liye jo program establish hone the, UNEP ka establishment ho gaya. Aajkal in today's world also you see lots of initiative of UNEP for the conservation of environment and for the safety of the environment. So United Nations Environmental Program was established and designed to promote environmental practice across the globe. And worldwide duty di gayi ki UNEP jo hai wo environment ko promote karne ke liye, ya environmental practices, good environmental practices ko promote karne ke liye, or for the conservation of our environment, or to save our environment, it will work. UNEP has coordinated the subsequent Earth Summit. Uske baad what happened that after that it was the responsibility of UNEP to coordinate these Earth Summit periodically, right? Then in 1980s some of the small steps were taken, right? In year 1980s some of the small steps were taken. You can see here 1980s some small steps were taken. So in 1982 Earth Summit time again, right? But the Cold War was at its height. But us samay pure world mein Cold War ka time chal raha tha. The world was distracted, so they were not focused towards environment. And the meeting held in Nairobi, Kenya, right? So Kenya mein 1982 mein jo hai Earth Summit ki meeting hui and was considered ineffective. वहां पे बहुत ज्यादा नॉट अ सिग्निफिकेंट डेवलपमेंट वॉज देयर. सो इट वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी एन इनइफेक्टिव सॉर्ट ऑफ मीटिंग बिकॉज द कोल्ड वॉर वॉज गोइंग ऑन एंड नोबडी वॉज इंटरेस्टेड इन एनवायरमेंट. राइट, नोबडी वॉज इंटरेस्टेड इन एनवायरमेंट. राइट, जैसे आप आज के टाइम में देखते हैं कि अभी कोविड चल रहा है, सो एवरीवन इज टुवर्ड्स कोविड. राइट, कि कोरोना वायरस से कैसे, अब किसी को कोई कंसर्न नहीं है. राइट, दो इट हैव ऑटोमेटिकली कम आउट टू बी दैट इट इज अ रिवाइवल पॉलिसी फॉर नेचर ड्यूरिंग दिस लॉकडाउन टाइम, बट स्टिल. सो सिमिलरली दैट टाइम द कोल्ड वॉर वॉज गोइंग ऑन एंड नोबडी वॉज इंटरेस्टेड. सो दिस नैरोबी मीटिंग इन केनिया 1982 वॉज नॉट दैट सिग्निफिकेंट एंड नथिंग फ्रूटफुल हैपन, कुछ बहुत ज्यादा हो नहीं पाया उस मीटिंग में. देन आफ्टर दैट इन 1983 द यूनाइटेड नेशन जनरल असेंबली created the UN World Commission on Environment. These things you have to remember properly, that in 1983, United Nations World Commission on Environment on Development, UNDP, United Nations Commission on Environment and Development, right? ये हमारे सामने आया, मतलब इसको बनाया गया. It was created by United Nations General Assembly, संयुक्त संघ जो है आपका. So it appointed Dr. Gro Harlem Brundtland. So, ये नाम काफी इंपॉर्टेंट है, राइट, बिकॉज सून यू विल सी दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हैव बीन डन बाय दिस. सो शी वाज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ नॉर्वे, राइट. सो डॉक्टर ग्रो हार्लेम ब्रुटलैंड, बेसिकली ब्रुटलैंड याद रखते हैं सब लोग. शी वाज अ चेयरपर्सन एंड फोर ईयर लेटर, आफ्टर फोर ईयर शी पब्लिश्ड द ब्रुटलैंड रिपोर्ट. दिस वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. So 4 years later, she published the Brundtland report and coined the term sustainable development, जिसको आप सतत विकास बोलते हैं. हमने आपको बताया भी था that resources should be used in such a manner that they are utilized for the present generation as well as there should be resources for the future generation so the upcoming generation can also use, and this is called as sustainable development. And first time Brundtland report when it came, the term sustainable development was coined there. Right. So the report combines environmental and economic consideration. As I told you that we should have such kind of development that we should combine environmental and economic consideration. And famously, they define sustainability. We have already studied sustainability term, that the development that meets the need of the present without compromising the ability of the future generation to meet their own needs. So I have told you that sustainability is a long-term goal. And the development should be done in such a manner that whatever resources or whatever sources are available from the nature to us in the present, we should use them in such a manner or preserve them in such a manner or make them utilize in such a manner so that they remain something for our future generation or our successors, our children, our grandchildren, right? So sustainability become the buzzword. So from this report, Brundtland report, the term sustainability and sustainable development was quite clear to the world that ki hame koi bhi development jo hai wo aise karna hai so that our environment should not be damaged. So sustainable development and sustainability words, they were like on the tongue of everyone after this Brundtland report, right? Every environmental lover. Now let's talk ahead. Then 1990s mein जब फर्दर हम आगे मूव किए विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द टाइम स्केल, सो 1990s में वी सॉ दैट ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, राइट, बिकॉज ऑफ द एक्सेसिव ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट ऑफ द अर्थ, जो एंथ्रोपोजेनिक एक्टिविटीज हो रही है, जो एमिशंस आपके इतने सारे बढ़ गए हैं, जो ग्रीन हाउस गैस आप एमिट कर रहे हैं, कि CO2 बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ गया, मीथेन बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ गया, N2O बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ गया, राइट. Then we have tropospheric ozone bahut zyada badh gaya. Then we have chlorofluorocarbon. So all these, so this decade, Earth Summit occurred in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, 1992. This is important information, that Earth Summit which happened in Rio de Janeiro in 1992. So this could be asked that Earth Summit occurred in Rio de Janeiro in 1992, and this Earth Summit, it emphasizes how the planet's environmental problems are linked to the economy, that how developing the economy or only industrial and economical development is responsible for creating so many problems for our environment, and the social justice issue, because it's a problem for everyone, Right. Who pollutes, that doesn't matter. But it's a problem of everyone. For example, a rich person do pollute our environment, but it will be faced by everyone, a poor or a rich, everyone, because environment is for everyone. The world leaders agreed in this summit, Earth Summit, which occurred in 1992, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. So here, the global community or the world leader agreed to combat global warming. So this was the main highlight at Rio de Janeiro in 1992, that we have to combat the global warming. So because the global warming, you see, you have heard this word many times. So global warming is nothing because of the excessive anthropogenic emissions, the greenhouse effect which is happening. See, natural greenhouse effect, so natural greenhouse effect, if we talk about, it is necessary for maintaining the Earth's average temperature. But when we have excessive greenhouse effect, as we see, because of the huge amount of emissions of anthropogenic gases or greenhouse gases, then it is termed as global warming. Because of that, our average temperature of the Earth is increasing by a few degrees Celsius, right, year by year, right? So this was the main highlight. And then other things were also discussed there in Rio de Janeiro in 1992, Brazil, in the Earth Summit, that we need to protect our biodiversity and stop using dangerous poisons. So these three things came out from there. Teen cheeze nikal ke aayi wahan se. One was global warming. We have to stop. Then we have to protect our biodiversity. Jo humari jaiv vividhta hai, usko bachana hai. Then the third thing was we should stop using dangerous poison chemicals. Right. So these was the outcome from the Rio de Janeiro, Brazil 1992. But major issue was global warming. If you talk about majorly, global warming was the main agenda at Rio de Janeiro 1992, which was the major issue at Rio. And then we talked a bit about Kyoto Protocol. Basically, Kyoto Protocol is for the curb down the greenhouse gas emissions, right? So it was introduced, this term Kyoto Protocol was introduced at Rio de Janeiro, and it requires signatories to cut carbon dioxide. So many of the countries, they were in favor that we should cut down the greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, their emission we should cut down, right? Carbon dioxide emissions by 5% between 2008 and 2012. So this was kept ki hame apne emissions ko kam karna chahiye because it is increasing the global warming. And in 2002, Johannesburg Earth Summit was done. So this was in between the 2002 Johannesburg Earth Summit was done. So this was lecture one and a bit introduction about how the environmentalism developed. Hope you enjoy this lecture, and you should keep learning and keep studying the subject, and should be more aware about your environment, because there is lot of issues which needs to be solved in environmental sciences, right? And if people will take them, people are aware and they take them as a challenge and do some solution-based science, then something can happen. Hope you enjoy this lecture. Thank you very much. We will be soon coming with the next lecture on the other unit. Thank you.